If you eat in a restaurant in the US, you're expected to tip. It's just the right thing to do. But what if I told you that tipping has a racist past? And it's not because black waiters get smaller tips than their white coworkers, or the tip minimum wage just makes the poor poorer. It's that the custom of tipping in America was racist from the very beginning. And it goes all the way back to slavery. Tipping started among European aristocrats in the 17th century. Rich Americans adopted the practice in the mid-1800s, and it spread throughout the country after the Civil War. Here's why. According to research by activist Saru Jaraman, newly freed slaves were flocking to major cities to find work. But they were only hired for jobs that were considered unskilled, mostly in restaurants. So racist restaurant owners embraced tipping as a way to hire freed slaves without actually having to pay them any wages. And customers were down with this new practice because they believed it was natural to tip their inferiors. Racism and classism run deep. So by the late 1880s, black workers accounted for nearly half of the hospitality industry. Then in the 20s, restaurants that were losing money because of the prohibition laws encouraged tipping, making it even more popular. Over time, tipping became the norm, and thanks to the powerful lobbying of the restaurant industry in 1938, Congress passed America's first minimum wage law, allowing states to set a lower wage for tipped workers. In 1996, the then head of the National Restaurant Association, Herman Cain, convinced a Republican-led Congress to set a two-tiered wage system for tipped and non-tipped workers. The tipped minimum wage was set at $2.13 per hour. Today, in 17 states, the legal minimum wage for tipped workers? Still only $2.13 per hour. A century later, the inherent racism of tipping persists. Non-white restaurant workers take home 56% less than their white peers. And now there's a new demographic that's suffering. Women. According to Jaraman, almost 66% of the 6 million tipped workers in America are women. Europe, where this whole thing began, has long moved past tipping to pay restaurant workers a full wage. So maybe it's time for America to change its tipping culture too.